Ammon's forces arrived here before we did. The temple may already be under his control.
Zeratul believed the other Zelnaga were here, and that they would stand with us against Ammon. They could end the war. My people could be free once again.
Then why have the Zelnaga not answered us?
I am going into the Ulnar Temple alone, Matriarch. I do not intend to risk any more lives.
You risked your own life on the word of a traitor.
He killed your mother, Vorazun. That is true. But he was never a traitor. I do not wish for death. Only to see Zeratul's visions fulfilled.
You will return. That much, I believe.
Since we arrived here, the Keystone has reacted strangely. It's as if it is attuned to the energies below.
Energies below?
Yes. Void energies exude from this place. I believe this world is a conduit between dimensions.
And the Keystone?
Acts as if siphoning these energies. This is entirely different from how the origin point information was stored. As if the Keystone was reconfigured for a second purpose.
Let us hope that the Zelnaga themselves can reveal the truths you're looking for.
Adun Toridas, Hierarch.
Vorazun, I know not what I shall find below, but I know I must go alone. You are in command of the Spear of Adun now.
Until you return, Artanis.
I have come seeking the Zelnaga.
This place, the Temple of Unification. The Zelnaga are somewhere within.
So far, all I've encountered are hybrid. I've been fighting them for days. Progress has been difficult.
The prophecies foretell of two ascended races working together to seek out the halls of revelation within the temple. Only with both present will the shrines reveal the means to awaken the slumbering Xel'Naga.
I've never cared much for prophecy.
And yet, despite our history, here we stand, together. Perhaps you should start. Into the void. All of this time, they have waited for us to assemble the keystone and find our way here. Amon indwells my people, possessing them through the Kala. But he has no physical form. If he were separated from the Templar, he could be forced back into the void.
Come on, Artanis. We've still got a long way to go.
We'll be right back.
breather. You're up, Artanis.
Together, we are strong.
The shrines look like they're covered with pictograms. How do you know what they say?
Communing with the shrine is more than reading carvings. Each atom of the stone has been placed with meaning, purpose. It was here, from Ulnar, that the Xel'Naga began to seed the universe with life. They created us. Just as they gave life to a numberless assembly of races in other universes. Every time, they observe and identify the potential of their offspring, never interfering. The infinite cycle will always be the same. Two races are destined to emerge. One, pure of essence, an indomitable spirit capable of great change, and one, pure of form, a being capable of vast psionic potential, able to house the essence of a Xel'Naga. Purity of essence and form, the Zerg and the Protoss. But if the Xel'Naga do not interfere, then it was Amon who uplifted my people. All we thought was the Xel'Naga was a lie.
Come on, Artanis. We're not far from having some answers.
I believe this must be the final hall.
Wait. The doors are open. The construct's destroyed.
The shrine is under attack! This can only be the work of me. We delay no more.
Civilizations grew, fell, and formed again. They will awaken when the two destined races arrive. Then, the elders among them will give their lives to bestow their essence. And pure of form and pure of essence will be reborn as Xel'Naga, shepherds of the infinite cycle.
So, what do you say? Ready to meet your maker?
Indeed. Come. The Chamber of Ascension lies ahead, and our salvation within.
Something's not right here.
Amon, the firstborn shall fear you no longer!